We were watching this at my house as well. In addition to Monday Night Football, Zion making his official preseason debut last night and put on a highlight show for the fans in Atlanta. Max, I'll start with you. What'd you think of your guy Zion's debut?
Exactly what I thought. He's a physical phenom. He's spectacular to watch. He is, it's whether or not he ever becomes an MVP level player, and I think he can, I think that's going to be some ways off, because what we really need to see is him being able to hit shots consistently from the outside. And although he is a rim defender, even at his size, and to be and have enough wit. I don't need to get into it here, but is he a reliable narrator? He has enormous business interests in China. And he, you know, you operate at the pleasure of the Chinese government. So that's not a reliable narrator, even if he's a brilliant guy, you know, well-educated, you know, a amazing entrepreneurial career, and I'm sure much more versed in the issue than, say, I am. And yet I can't take his word for it, because he has enormous business interests. And China exerts enormous pressure. South Park has an episode about how much they censor, China can censor speech really around the world through business pressure. The irony is the communist government can do that through business pressure. And so people's reactions initially, the knee-jerk response, especially in the media that's afraid to say anything about bad Daryl Morey. That's essentially the thrust of it, bad Daryl Morey. Mm-hmm. Daryl Morey didn't do anything wrong. He just tweeted a simple, the sentiment was good. People should be free, essentially what he says. If you have a problem with that, that's your problem. I don't mean you personally, Stephen A. I mean whoever has a problem with that sentiment, that people should be free. Okay, so you have a problem with it. I don't.
Okay. I appreciate your perspective. I don't mind taking on my shoulders. I got a problem with it because it wasn't smart, plain and simple. I respect the hell out of Daryl Morey. Daryl Morey is a good man. Daryl Morey is an elite executive. I hope he keeps his job and continues to flourish as executive for the Houston Rockets. But that does not mean that he's infallible, that he's devoid of a mistake. And this was one of them, no matter what way you slice it. And the reason why I point to it being a mistake, Max Kellerman, is because of what you started off by saying. Mutual interest. With respect to Senator Ted Cruz and others on Capitol Hill who came out and spoke glowingly in support of Daryl Morey. Ask them how many times they've had to bite their tongue in the interest of the United States of America, in the interest of whatever dealings were in our best interest as we were dealing with a communist China or somebody else. I'm quite sure that there are many occasions where they have to muzzle themselves and not speak up and speak out and speak open about every single thing, because it's not just their own personal interest that they're talking about here. They have to think about a greater good. So now we transition here to Daryl Morey. We have a Houston Rockets organization that has been ingratiating itself with China for over 20 years. They're the number one franchise in China. Why? Because Yao Ming used to play for them. Who's the president of the Chinese Basketball Association? It's Yao Ming. Who basically has been over here in America, and though he's loyal and patriotic and loves his nation, in the same breath, he greatly appreciates the benefits of being in the United States of America and wanted to sort of matriculate that into Chinese culture, per se, in the eyes of some people. Who's to say what he was doing behind the scenes? Who's to say what the Houston Rockets were doing behind the scenes? The NBA does business and has been doing business with China for many, many years. The individual athletes have been doing business with them, which is why James Harden was one of the first people to come out there and apologize. Because when you talk about the money that James Harden, to LeBron James, to Kobe, and others have made, think about the money that they make in China. I mean, you look at Stephon Marbury, he's a star over there. Ask Tracy McGrady about what it's like to do business in China. And those are just individuals. So when we understand the kind of business relationships that have been cultivated and the kind of impact as American citizens we can have on another culture, we do have a responsibility to sit up there and be careful about the things that they say. Nobody is saying that what Daryl Morey said he was wrong. Nobody in this country had better dare say that he was wrong about what he said. That is not the issue. Tillman Fertitta doesn't have an issue with Daryl Morey specifically because of what he said. Adam Silver doesn't have that issue. The NBA doesn't have that issue. What they have an issue with is that, why did you say it? Why did you feel the need to do it? Particularly when we're about to go there and perform and play. You've got a situation where now millions of dollars have been lost, jobs have been lost, and all of this stuff because a basketball executive wanted to send out a tweet that ain't even 140 damn characters. At some point in time, when you're sitting at, remember, Daryl Morey doesn't work for himself. He's sitting up there and he expressed himself as an individual, but he's a representative of the Houston Rockets. He gets a check from Tillman Fertitta. Oh, by the way, his check is ballooned because of his association with the National Basketball Association. Nobody knows this better than Daryl Morey. So to me, in closing, this is what I'm trying to say. I am so sick and tired of folks acting like you get to do what you want to do, say what you want to say, no matter how righteous you may be, regardless of the ramifications, while you got your hand out for somebody else's money
and
you're representing them. There's a level of sensitivity. There's a level of sensitivity that we're obligated. And Max, working as employees of ESPN, it is nothing short of hypocritical for us to take a different position, because guess what? Bob Iger, Jimmy Pitaro, Con Nichelle, and everybody that runs this organization. We work for Walt Disney. We work for ESPN. We don't get to just say
wait, do what we want to do.
Let's respond.
The logical conclusion of where you're going, if you go to its like absurd conclusion, I don't mean that your point is absurd. I mean, if you take it all the way to its logical conclusion, what that means is the powers that be must kowtow to the powers that be. You must acquiesce constantly. What you're saying is, like, for example, editorial policy anywhere, here or anywhere else, we can make the decision that we can live with it and work within those rules. Or we may feel, no, I have to make a principled stand at a certain point and then deal with the consequences. And history actually smiles on the principled. That's what happened, you know.
When
Teddy Roosevelt invited Booker T. Washington to the White House, there were editorials all throughout the South, and people were, you know, wanted another civil war practically. And this is, you have to consider, it's not just you, it's this entire nation. Did he do the right thing or not?
Max, yeah, I appreciate your historical perspective. Now let me give you a little bit of history as a black person. Remember Rosa Parks refusing to give up her seat on the bus? Excuse me, did you know that she was chosen? There were people who sat on a bus before her. She was chosen. You know why? Because she was the perfect candidate to bring attention to the issues during civil rights that obviously vexed us as a community. When you thought about the march from Selma to Montgomery, excuse me, that was planned, that was orchestrated, that was coordinated to produce a desired effect. That wasn't somebody speaking willy-nilly.
So
emotionally, with a sentence or whatever. I'm saying to you, when you say something like that, it's not about kowtowing to executives or anything like that. It's about addressing the greater good. You're not addressing the greater good because you decide to throw out a 100-word or a 50-word tweet and then, oh, by the way, deleted it when the heat came up and tried to clarify it thereafter. Listen, you got to take all of these things into perspective.
He may have not
considered. These are facts.
He may have not thought it all the way through. Or maybe he didn't realize the extent of the backlash.
Does he not have an obligation to think it all the way through? That's my point.
You're still standing up for the behavior of a repressive communist government that will exert economic pressure to silence people.
No, that's not true. That's a misrepresentation.
You
should be ashamed of yourself for saying that.
Wait a minute.
That's a misrepresentation of my
position. I understand Joseph Tsai, the owner of the Nets, who's, again, he's lived it, so understands the issue better than others, but not a reliable narrator because he has enormous business interests there. I understand Adam Silver says he's aware he doesn't want to offend, you know, our friends in China and the fans in China. I get it. But do we really know what the level of outrage is since there isn't freedom of speech?
We don't even know.
Hold on, Molly, before we close. I would remind you that throughout this world, one of the things that exist is the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. I don't see folks outside of the Jewish community talking about that too often.
Okay,
why?
Guys,
because
let's
guess
do
what?
This.
When
let's
you open your
this.
Mouth, You have to be careful.
Okay, let's take a commercial break. Sometimes, obviously, your moral compass trumps business interests. We saw it can cost you your job. Look at the Colin Kaepernick. Let's get a commercial break in. We will get into Zion, and maybe we'll discuss
as
well. Zion burst onto the NBA scene last night, but were Max and Stephen A. impressed with the Phenom's debut? That's coming up later. First take.